So we are entering this week the new moon of Aquarius, yay! After the Capricorn energy and the heaviness of the Capricorn energy, and I had few conversations with Capricorn friends since Pluto entered Capricorn. Our Capricorn friends are going deep into their emotions, and all kind of things were coming up during the whole month. So now we entering a complete different energy, a complete different atmosphere, which is the atmosphere of Aquarius, with the new moon of Aquarius happening exactly this week. So what are we to expect from this atmosphere, from this energy for all of us? Because every one of us is going to be bathing in a complete different energy than the one we had before. Now, first of all, it's no coincidence that we are calling, you know, the time that we are in right now, the age of Aquarius. This is the way it's called. It could have been called anything else, but it's called the age of Aquarius. From the point of view of the Kabbalah, the age of Aquarius started in the time of the Ari, 400 years ago in the 16th century. So every time we enter the month of Aquarius, immediately we're going to relate it to what the Kabbalist talked about, which Aquarius is all about the knowledge. When we take a look at the icon of the Aquarius, or the symbol, it's a man that is pouring a bucket of water. So it's like, it's strange, it's a bucket. What does it mean? Why is it a bucket and why is it water? Because the Kabbalah explains that the water, it's all the flow of knowledge, it's opening all the boundaries. There is no boundaries in water. We can't put frontiers even between states. It's very difficult to place a frontier in the middle of the sea because it's endless and it's really boundless. So we are entering a month where, number one, the lesson is all about I can. Aquarius doesn't understand I can't. A real Aquarius doesn't have fears. If fears will come from other signs that are in a person's chart, for instance, but a true real Aquarius, say an Aquarius with a rising and moon in Aquarius, knows no fear, because in their mind everything is possible. They can do anything, they can fly. So I had a conversation with another friend Aquarius last week that told me, you know, every night I dream I'm flying, and it feels so good because Aquarius can fly. There is something about them that can do, make the impossible possible, that can push the boundaries of everything. That's the reason why many inventors were under the sign of Aquarius, because they thought immediately outside of the box. So we are entering a place where everything is possible. We have to be out of the box. We cannot continue copying and pasting the same patterns that we had so far. We have to open ourselves up to new opportunities and new ventures. And it's also the month of knowledge. It's also the month of knowing. It's also the month to connect with better visions that we have about our life, to connect with my ultimate potential. It's the week to ask myself, wait, I've been doing everything that I'm doing for X amount of years or month. Where is my potential? What should I be? What am I capable to become? And that's the window of opportunity that opens up. And the age of Aquarius for all of us also means that we are in a very, very special time. You know, and Karen, our teacher, likes to call it like the dark moment before the dawn actually starts. But in this dark moment, we see how much knowledge can be now spread with, you know, Facebook, with other all kind of technological means, which are also connected to the month of Aquarius. So I want us this week to dream big, to dream very, very big, and to really bring these dreams into more manifestations in our life. So for everybody, have a terrific month of Aquarius, and we'll see you next week.